Well, handling this Nevada team here out of the gates has been a challenge here for Loyola, as is handling this stage. This program is not used to this. Ohio State head coach Chris Holtman was concerned about the layoff. Coming into this game, they had played twice in 20 days. That's because of a bye happening at the end of the regular season, a pushed-up conference tournament. Clever telling me Dean Wade is out for the rest of the game. He told me I couldn't, out of good conscience, play him when he's got maybe a future of basketball ahead of him. And perhaps this team rallying around its leader, Barry Brown, who has always been front and center in terms of setting the tone. And he did it again in the opening huddle with his team. He told his guys, look, guys, out of 16 teams that are left, people think we are ranked 16th. Now that follows his routine for the regular season. For every Big 12 game, he grabbed his guys in the opening huddle and he told his teammates right before they played, just remember, we were picked 8th in the preseason.
Back out to Atlanta, where Lisa Byington is with Sister Jean from Loyola.
What will you tell them when you go in the locker room?
Well, I already told them as they came off the court, great game. And they said, one of them said to me, Clayton said, we broke your bracket, Sister Jean. I said, I don't care that you broke my bracket.
What do you have, Lisa?
Well, South Dakota State has baited Ohio State to shoot the three the last couple of times. The word in the huddle, hey, we've given up 33 attempts. If we let them shoot 40, we actually will have a chance to win this ball game. Of course, Ohio State's got to miss, but that is their strategy right now. They're going to continue to give that shot up.
Before the start of the second half, we check in with Lisa Byington.
I can't believe we're in this game is the quote that John Calipari told me as we're walking out of the locker room. He said, look, we shot terribly, 26%. A lot of our key players are in foul trouble. It is hard for me to understand how we are still in it. He told these guys there's very little freedom of movement in this game, but we have to withstand that. Additionally, they are going to go both man and zone defensively. Now, he told me to start in the second half, he's going to try out some man. They went heavily zone in the first half because of the foul trouble.
So Byington.
Yeah, that's a perfect description, Brian, about his huddle. He almost broke his whiteboard. And sometimes with coaches and in moments like this, it's not about the X's and O's. It's about the emotion. He looked at his players in the huddle and he said three times, do not quit. Think of how we got here, the number of people who are depending on you, the number of people who are watching you. You attack Loyola or we're all going home.
Coach is so right. Everything is perspective, how you look at it. And that's all right, Coach. You got a budget. Break that thing. Just don't hit one of your players by mistake.
Check in with Lisa quick.
Well, we're playing iso ball. That's what Eric Musselman told his team in the last huddle. He said, you know, we do want to shoot quick in the shot clock, but make sure it's a Nevada shot, guys. They have not hit a three-point shot, which is so important to their offense. Since 13:36 in the first half, they have missed the last 10 straight.
Let's check in with Lisa on the star shooter for Nevada, Caleb Martin. What do you have, Lisa?
Yeah, Brian, you were mentioning his left foot injury. Well, out of that last timeout, he takes his shoe off. You can see it there. In fact, he does it after every timeout. He says, it helps me air it out. The pain is pulsing. It's throbbing. I try to massage it, stretch it. I've tried a little bit of everything. Tape it, put pads on it, pain medication. And he admits, it definitely makes me second guess by jumping and explosiveness to the rim.
Check in with Lisa Byington.
Well, that sweet shooting stroke. Not only have we seen from Kata Bates Diop this first half, but we've seen from Mike Dom. He learned it from that woman right there, his mother, Michelle Hobson. She played at Wyoming. She was a Hall of Famer, played in the 80s, was the school's all-time leading scorer and rebounder. And when Mike was 4 or 5 years old, he would lay down with mom and they would practice flicking the wrist that you see there, work on the motions. He said they would lie in bed with my mom and they would just flick the wrist. We would play some shooting games. Mom loves it. So he got the shooting stroke from mom. I don't know where he got the raise the roof motion, though, guys. What do you think?
Well, he's up near the roof, so he could raise it if anybody could. And mom Dom is as big a part of his game as dad Dom is. Dad was a football player at Wyoming. Yeah, Mike Dom. He's a fun guy to watch. He was hardly recruited.
Back here in Atlanta, one of the storylines is that of worlds colliding and colliding in the state of Kansas. A couple of Kansas kids trying to beat Kansas State for the right to get to the Final Four. Loyola's Ben Richardson and Clayton Custer grew up in Overland Park, Kansas. They were buddies, they were teammates from elementary school, through middle school, through high school. They won championships at every level. They have a connection. You'll see it here tonight. We've already seen it in this tournament. First round against Miami. This is the hammer play, a big bucket to tie it with a minute to go, and they have fun reminiscing about it.
I know after he hit the three on the hammer play, we came back down the court, and I just like it's just like the look in the eye and like a high five, and it's like, it's just like it's on now. Like that was big. That was real big. Like we're gonna talk about this later, but like let's get a stop right now.
Was like a perfect example of us being able to have that togetherness on the court. And like what he said, we know we're gonna talk about it later and laugh about it. But in the moment, we try to keep our cool a little bit.
Lisa Byington with Bruce Weber.
You gave the ball to your leader to try to win it for you. Yeah. That kind of play, an isolation play for him up top. What about that play played to his strength at that moment?
He missed a bunch of them as a freshman and sophomore, and he made one a couple weeks ago against TCU. And now he's the guy you got to go to. He can make plays, and he missed a couple of them there down the stretch, but he made a big one at the end.
That play was called for you. Why did it work?
It worked because we kind of knew what they were going to do. They were kind of just spacing out, and so we knew they were going to use their athleticism to try and just block the shot at the end. And luckily, I was able to maneuver the ball around a little bit and put it where the defense wasn't.
You have been the person. You have been on this K-State team that has believed in this team from day one. What do you see in this team here that others do not?
I just see a lot of grit now. A lot of guys that love each other, and we play together, play defense the right way, and just play for each other. We're able to come out with the win.
I just want to thank all the fine, smart, clever journalists that didn't pick us. We got some great ones out there. And trust me, our guys were aware of that, so appreciate
again,
that.
Thank Thanks, you guys. For your attention.
You use that as motivation, guys.
At this time.
Sure, sure. We were a trendy upset pick. I understand it. Maybe we had something to do with that, with how we played in a couple games here late. But a lot of them are my friends. But sure, we made our guys aware of that.
They're going to cut these nets down. Gary Harkness knows all about this feeling that has not been felt in 55 years at Loyola Chicago. Let's send it to Lisa.
You just looked at me and you looked at your fan base and you said, look at that. What do you see when you look at that?
I see God is good. That's what I see. God has blessed me on my journey. He's blessed his university. And this group of guys are resilient. So the first, the glory goes to him. The second of all, the journey of with these guys, it's an unbelievable group. It's amazing when you believe. I mean, they have believed and believed and believed, and it's awesome to see. I just want to stare at them celebrating.
How did a small Division I school in Chicago get to the Final Four?
It's the accumulation of a lot of people. It's not one person. It's accumulation of a group that is resilient and tough and believes and invested. How much these kids invested? This just didn't happen 2 weeks ago. But it's not one person. It's not one player. It's a collaboration of a lot of tough, high character people.
What do you think your mentor, Rick Majerus, what do you think your mentor, the late Rick Majerus, would say about this accomplishment?
I've been blessed with two mentors, Tony Barone and Coach Rick Majerus. And Coach Majerus was, he was adamant. He's like, you got to take this job. You know, he said, we were building something there. He goes, you got to take this job. You're from Chicago area, Jesuit school. So I think he'd be happy with the type of kids we got and how we play the game. And that's what he would love about this.
Congrats. Go enjoy. Bring in the Kansas kids. Ben Richardson, Clayton Custer. Everybody dreams about what you guys are doing right now. To be best friends, to be roommates, to win championships, to get to the Final Four. How does this reality compare to the dream?
I mean, I don't know. I was just telling Clay over there, like, it doesn't even feel real. I can't even put it into words right now. I mean, it's surreal to be able to come out. We had so much support. Like, they all came down. They've been going wild all weekend. And to do this with Clay, you know, after all the hours we put in together, and we believed that we could do something like this, do something really special, because we knew we had such good chemistry and we've got such a good group. And you know, everyone would say we're crazy. If we said that this was gonna happen, people would call us crazy, but you just gotta believe, and you gotta believe in all the work that you put in, and we put in so many hours together, and it's paying off.
Clayton, why did crazy work for this team?
Wait, sorry.
I said he called it crazy, so I'm asking, why did crazy work for this team?
I mean, it's because we all believe in each other.
I mean, for me and Ben and for everybody, like, we're a bunch of guys that everybody laughed at us when we thought we were going to play Division I basketball. Nobody thought that we could do any of this.
Let me tell you a story. In the hotel yesterday, a girl came up and said, hey, can I get a picture with you guys? She goes, here, mister, can you take the picture? She handed the phone to him.
And she goes, are you on the team? And I was like, come on, man. But hey, we believe in ourselves. And I know I said Marcus was the best player on the floor last game. Ben Richardson was the best player on the floor tonight.
You certainly were. A career high in points, a career high in threes made. Why was it your night?
I mean, you know, we've been saying the whole tournament, it doesn't really matter who it is, but we got a ton of guys that can go and make shots and have a big game. And the way this team is so unselfish, the ball usually finds the hot hand or the open guy. And so I think, you know, we've shown in this tournament, everyone's had a big night, and the ball has really found that guy. And tonight it just happened to be me. And you know, I was up for the challenge, and I'm grateful for
and
that.
And for the record, I'm gonna be mad at Ben for telling that story to the whole world after this.
I had to get him.
Only a few million were listening. Don't worry about it. Thank you, guys. Go enjoy. Okay, Brian.
That's great stuff.